You kindly, for those who will be able to open their camera, kindly open your camera. I will be discussing only 1 hour, and I will give you the rest of the time to do your outputs for those who have not yet submitted their outputs.
AUX mode.
Would like to congratulate everybody for being able, for those who have who were able to submit their outputs. I will be finalizing my midterm examination, midterm grade for today. So I'll be giving you time to do your outputs for those who have not yet finished their outputs, and then you submit as soon as possible. Okay, because I will be the deadline for encoding of the midterm grade is today. So for those who are not yet able to submit their outputs, please be advised to do so as soon as possible. So at any rate, I will be providing you, or I will be discussing with you some of the simulations again for the topics that we have. So I'm discussing energy for the meantime. Okay, so let me just look on the topics that we have for energy. Okay. So let me see. Let me just start with the this one. Are you able to, can you see what I am sharing on my screen?
Yes, po.
Yes, po.
Okay, sige. So, no problem with this?
Wala naman po, ma'am.
Okay. So, I will be discussing with you masses in the springs. There. Can you see what I am sharing?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So, when we talk about masses in the springs, remember that the last time that we discussed is all about motion, and we are concerned with linear motion. So this time we are concerned with having springs. So when you say springs, this is definitely an elastic material. So whenever we induce, or whenever we produce, or whenever we apply forces to the spring, the spring would deform. So such deformation can be measured, and that deformation will have to be determined in order to find out what's the effect force that has been applied to the spring. So in the spring, we may have spring constant. So you would notice here that we have the spring constant. So there are two springs here, and we are going to determine the we are going to show the natural length. This is the natural length, the one in blue colored dashed line, and then you have the equilibrium position. Later on, it will be shown. So the equilibrium position will show that is the position of the spring by which stable condition is applied. So that means whenever we induced force or load to the spring, there is a corresponding equilibrium position, meaning that position is the location wherein the spring is in equilibrium or stable condition. And then, of course, you will be shown also the movable line. So the movable line is the line in which the spring will be having motion. So let us try. So let us try simulating, and show. Let me show to you how do we how do we determine or how do we simulate, show how the spring would work under certain conditions. So let's say, for example, we provide a, or we add 50 gram here for the first spring. So remember, we have here the spring constant. So let us try the spring constant. This is small. Let us try the spring constant. This is small for both. Okay. We add here 50 gram. I mean, so you would notice. You would notice here the blue one, position, and the green one is the equilibrium position. Meaning, at that particular position in the green one, the dashed line in green color, that means that is the area where there is a stable condition.
I was mentioning a while ago, this one, when we add the 50 gram load in the first spring, you would notice you have here the motion, and this one is the natural length. That is the position, initial position of the spring. So let us try on that. That is the initial position of the spring. And when you add the 50 gram, you would notice we have here the green dashed line. The green dashed line is the equilibrium position, meaning at that particular portion, that would be the stable condition. The spring would not move anymore. But when you go to this one, the red one, that is the movable line. So let us say we add 50 gram here. Take note that our spring constant here is small. We are going to compare it with the second spring that we have here. So the second spring, let us use the maximized or the extreme value. So we are going to use this extreme spring constant here. So we are going to use a large spring constant for spring number two. So we are going to let me just finish with this one. I cannot. That's okay. What do you notice with the movement?
Maiksi lang po.
Mabilis po.
Yes. What happens to the spring?
Hindi po masyadong spring.
Okay, so yung movement niya hindi ganon kabilis. Ano, at hindi ganon ka kahaba yung naabot ng kanyang movement, unlike dun sa isa kanina. So let us try if we use a smaller spring constant. So what happens now? Okay. What do you notice?
Kapag kumakapal po yung spring, mas maikli po yung movement.
Okay, mas maiksi yung movement. Okay. So once we add, let's try it to the other side. We've got the same, spring constant is small. But what we did was to double the load. What happens? Okay, you would notice on the first spring, what we did was to add up another 50 gram. And you would notice here, this one, another, the equilibrium position, mas mababa na compared dun sa isang merong spring constant na small din, pero ang load niya 50 gram. So let us try using the same load, 50 gram to the other one, okay? But we are going to adjust the spring constant. So we are going to use a spring constant of a large value. What do you notice? What can you conclude? Given the same load of 50 gram, what can you conclude? Anyone? What can you conclude?
The larger the spring constant, the lesser the movement.
Okay, so the deformation, let's take it slow. Okay, so you can appreciate it more. Once we use both the spring constant, both spring constant here, okay, let us remove first both load. Okay, so that is the original or the state, initial state condition. If we use here 100 kilogram, and then the other one is 50 kilogram. So you would notice the natural length is both in the same position. The movable line is in the same position. However, the equilibrium position differs. The equilibrium position of the spring with a load of 50 gram is shorter as compared to the spring with a 100 gram load. Okay? So, let me see. You would notice here, if you are going to measure the equilibrium position, the one in green, dashed green line, you've got 65 units here. But if you will notice, the other one is at 80 units. Okay? So that would mean the load has an effect to the spring. So the higher the load, the larger the deformation is. That can be our conclusion. However, let me just change the condition. So we are going to use the same. Let's use the same. Okay, so you would notice we use now the same load, the same 100 gram for both spring one and spring two. But we are going to make the spring constant, to change the spring constant of the first spring. What do you notice? Anyone, what do you notice?
Nixie po yung movement.
Okay, so you would notice here the equilibrium position for the first spring becomes shorter. Okay. From the small spring constant with 80 units as the equilibrium position, once we add or we increase the spring constant, you would notice here we have the length for the equilibrium position become shorter. So what will be your conclusion? What now can you conclude? Anybody? Given the same load of 100 gram, but what we did was to differentiate or to make a different spring constant for both spring. What can you conclude?
Nixie po
Anyone?
Ma'am, the larger spring constant, the smaller the equilibrium position.
Okay, so the shorter the equilibrium position. So that means the spring constant is directly proportional or inversely proportional to the equilibrium position. Ulit? What's your
inversely.
Okay, inversely proportional. How about the load? Let's say that is P, the 100 gram. What can you conclude? The same, if you are going to use the same spring constant, let us remove the 50 gram and let us use the 100 gram to the other side and let us use the 50 gram here. What can you conclude? Relative to the load, what can you conclude? So let's say we add up here, what would happen? We add a load here. Let's say we add a load here. What do you notice?
As the mass doubles, the deformation of the spring also doubles.
The deformation also doubles. Can we conclude that? With this particular case, we don't know yet the distance. Okay, we have no no ruler.
Heavier the load.
Okay, the heavier the load. Oh, diba? Palitan
the
natin
the
to.
Distance, the
okay, so ibig sabihin the longer the deformation of the spring will be, di ba? Okay?
Yes.
Okay, so you're going to notice, di ba? If you're going to notice, if we put here 50 gram, you would notice that the equilibrium position here becomes in this portion. But we cannot say that it is doubled. Although, however, we cannot say that it's doubled. So you would notice here you have the 50 gram. Although we doubled the 50 gram with 100 gram, the equilibrium position cannot be concluded that it has doubled. Okay? Because you would notice here from the 50 gram, you would notice here we have 65 units of equilibrium position, while this one is 80 units of equilibrium position. Although, we can conclude that the heavier or the larger the load we provide or we apply to the spring, the larger the or the longer the deformation will be or the equilibrium position will be. Okay? So that means the load is directly proportional or inversely proportional to the equilibrium position?
Directly proportional.
Okay, directly proportional. So you would notice here, so that's how we apply. So you would notice here, apply the load. So you would notice here, we have a portion here of gravity. Okay, so remember that in Earth we do have the gravity, but in other planets we don't have the gravitational pull as that of the Earth. So we will have here considering the Earth. Okay, so doon na lang tayo sa condition na kung saan nandun tayo. So considering that we are on Earth, and let's say that the gravity is, there is a lot of gravity. What do you notice to the spring? What do you notice to the spring? Anyone? What do you notice to the spring? We move the gravity to none. But when we move it to lots to the extreme, what happens to the spring?
Nag-i-increase.
Ah, diba? Pagka binaulit, balik, dun muna sa inalis natin yung gravity, what happens to the spring?
Nag-move na po upward.
Okay, so the spring moves up and down motion given the load that they have been applied to or subjected to. But when the gravitational pull increases, what happens? You would notice the equilibrium position. What happens to the equilibrium position when there is no gravity? The equilibrium position is the same as the natural length. And you would notice that the spring moved up and down. But once the gravitational pull has been applied, what happens to the equilibrium position?
Goes down.
Anong nangyayari doon sa equilibrium position?
Goes downward.
Okay, so nagbumababa yung equilibrium position natin. So dito, you would notice, nandun sa katapat ng natural length yung equilibrium position. So wala kang makikitang equilibrium position. Ibig sabihin, unbalanced yan. There is a probability na unbalanced. Kaya pag walang gravitational pull, nakalutang lang ang mga objects. Pero once merong gravity, okay, nag-move yung equilibrium position, you notice yung green line. And then if there is lots of gravitational pull, ayan yung nangyayari, nag-move yung equilibrium position. So let us try, lagay lang natin doon sa middle. Ito ay medyo ano lang, yung hindi naman masyadong malaki yung gravitational pull natin. And we're going to use the gravitational pull of the Earth. Okay. So that is our ideal condition. Okay. Okay. So let us try using a larger, okay. Okay, that you would notice a larger spring constant. Okay, so that's how it is applied. So let's say, let us use another condition. You would notice we have two different springs here. One is shorter, the other is longer. The other one is longer. So the first one has about 23 units. The second one is about 48 units. So the constant parameter is that we are going to use a constant spring. Let us use constant thickness. So that means both dimensions of the spring are the same. So the spring constant, instead of the spring constant being the same, what we use was the thickness is constant. So if we, so let us try first the spring constant. If we apply, sorry, let's apply the 100 kilogram so we can check on. Okay. Okay, so that's what happened when we apply the 100 kilogram. Let's say the thickness is constant. What happens to the equilibrium condition? Equilibrium position. Given the spring constant, the equilibrium position of the first spring is at 40. The second is at 60. Okay. Okay, let's go first with the first one. Okay. So this one is the 40 units, but once we make use of thicker dimension, that would become 30. Okay, so you have the spring constant. This constant. Then once we increase the thickness, you would notice we have a different position, equilibrium position for the spring number one. Okay. So once we use a constant, a spring constant, and you have different spring constant here, if you have the same thickness, what happens to the springs? So you would notice you have the same load of 100 gram. The first spring will have a deformation of shorter than the second one, but you would notice that the movement of the first spring is faster as compared to the second spring. Take note that the first spring here is shorter than the second spring. Okay, so what can you conclude here? Anyone? What can you conclude? What can you conclude?
The length of the spring has a relationship with the distance of the equilibrium. For example, the shorter the spring, the shorter the distance of equilibrium.
Okay, so given the same load applied, the shorter spring would have shorter deformation or shorter change in equilibrium position. But the longer the spring, the longer the equilibrium position is changed also. Okay? So you would notice from the natural length, from the natural length of the first spring, it moved up to from 23 up to 32. So almost how many? 5, 6, 7 units ang nag-change dito sa second spring. From 48 naging 64. So how many? 48, 64 minus 48. How many units is that? Okay, so you have how many units was changed? From 64, from 48, it became 64. You have 16 units. The other one is almost 7 units lang. So mas malaki yung naging change sa equilibrium position nung mas mahabang spring kesa doon sa mas maiksing spring. So again, what can we conclude? What's your conclusion again? What can you conclude? Anyone? Ulit. Anybody? What can you conclude? Nawala na. Sige. Try natin to ha. Balikan ulit natin tong first condition natin. We're going to use the same. Okay. we're going to use here 50 gram. The question mark here is this one. Okay, alisin natin yan. Ilagay natin itong mas maliit. What can you say about the value? The one in question. Oh, we go back to the first condition. We have the same. Parehas na spring. Parehas ang spring constant din na ginamit natin. Pero naglagay tayo ng 50 gram here. What can you say about the load that I place here, yung naka-pink?
The mystery po is heavier than the first one.
Okay, so that's most probably mas malaki kesa saan? Anong value?
The 50 gram.
Okay, sa 50 gram. So most likely, ganun yung value niya. So once we use a larger value of this, a larger value of this, what do you notice? What do you notice?
Nag-move po upward yung equilibrium position.
Okay, so ibig sabihin mas umiksi na rin yung kanyang deformation. So wala tayong binago sa load. Wala tayong binago sa load, 'di ba? Sabi niyo mas malaki sa 50 gram yung load. So in other words, ano ang magiging conclusion natin dito sa ganitong sitwasyon? Ang binago lang natin yung spring constant. Yung naka-question mark na load, the same pa rin kasi hindi naman natin binago yon. We have the same, still larger than the 50 gram. Pero ano lang nangyari doon sa spring constant natin, nilalakihan natin. So ano ulit ang conclusion natin?
The spring constant is inversely proportional to the distance of equilibrium.
Equilibrium position. Okay. So that's how it works. Okay. Pero iba yung condition natin, iba yung magiging conclusion natin kapag ka, balikan naman natin to, pag ganito. Okay, let's say gumamit tayo dito ng 50 gram. Naglagay tayo dito ng 50 gram. Can you still conclude the same? Mas malaki pa rin ba yung 50, itong naka-question mark na load kesa dun sa 50 gram? Pwede pa rin ba nating sabihin na ganun?
Yes, po ma'am.
Sige nga, sabi nyo, yes, ano, mas malaki pa rin din sa 50 gram. So, how about, lapalitan natin, gawin natin 100 gram. Mas malaki pa rin ba dun sa 100 gram yung load na pink?
Yes po.
Try natin yung 250. Mas malaki pa rin?
Hindi na po. Mas maliit na po yung mystery gram po na sa kanan kaya sa kaliwa.
Sure tayo doon?
Yes po.
Yes po.
Sige ha. Tignan natin. Okay. So balikan ulit natin yung spring constant. Balik natin ito. Spring constant lang ang ating constant na parameter. Hindi natin alam ngayon, variable na ngayon yung thickness. Maaaring ito mas makapal yung spring number 2 kesa dun sa spring number 1. So lagyan ulit natin ng 50 gram. Can we conclude na mas malaki yung pink na load kesa dito sa 50 gram?
Hindi po.
O, hindi na natin mako-conclude na ganun, di ba? Can we conclude na mas malaki kaysa 100 gram? yung load na yon?
Hindi rin.
O, hindi na rin tayo makasigurado. Sa 250?
Hindi rin po.
Hindi rin tayo masyado makakasigurado. Ano? So, in other words, merong effect. Anong conclusion natin doon? Merong effect yung
spring constant.
Yung length.
Okay. So, marami kang i-consider. May spring constant, merong thickness, may yung dimension, at meron ding length. Diba? Na nabigay ba sa inyo yung, di ba meron na kayong mechanics of deformable bodies? Na subject? Wala pa?
Wala pa po.
Okay, sige. So later on, pag meron na kayo nung course na yon ng mechanics of deformable bodies, may encounter nyo na yung mga formula niya, mga spring-spring na yan. Okay? So dito lang, basic lang yung pinapakita ko sa inyo. Okay, let us try vector. Oh, when you say vector this time, we are going to consider the velocity, the acceleration, the displacement. Ibig sabihin, meron na tayong motion. Yung kanina kasi, yung binigay kong introduction, pinakita lang natin dun sa yung spring, ano ang magiging effect ng load dun sa mga spring. Pero kung meron tayong ganito, consider natin yung velocity, yung acceleration, may displacement tayo, mass equilibrium, tsaka movable line. So, dinagdagan na natin ngayon ng velocity and acceleration. Let us use gravity. Wag na yung muna yung by gravity. We've got the same spring constant for both springs, for spring 1 and 2. We add here 50 gram. Pakita natin yung gravity spring. And then the other one, we are going to use this one. What do you notice? The green arrow is the velocity. The yellow arrow is the acceleration. What do you notice?
They are inversely proportional to each other.
Alin ang inversely proportional?
The relationship between velocity and acceleration is inversely proportional.
Yung 50 gram, you would notice. Okay. Ito yung upward. Paras upward siya. Paano naging inversely proportional? Ulit. Paano naging inversely proportional? Yung direction ba ang sinasabi nyo? Baka nalilito lang kayo doon sa arrow, ha? Pa-double check nyo. Kasi yung arrow na green, it just show the direction of the velocity. The direction of the acceleration, yung yellow. So, dito sa 50 gram, yung velocity downward, downward din yung acceleration. Pero you would notice dito sa 100 gram, okay? Dito sa case na to, downward yung velocity, upward yung acceleration. So, ibig sabihin, nag-i-increase yung acceleration niya. Pero, okay. Pero merong time na parehas na yung direction ng velocity at ng acceleration. Okay. Aha. Palitan natin to. Gawin natin parehas na 100 gram para hindi ano. Say, 100 gram sila parehas. Okay, parehas lang na nangyayari, di ba? Okay. So, yung net force natin nandito. Okay, pakita lang natin yung net force. Sige, yung net force na lang muna. Okay, yung black, yun yung net force. Pero pag ang forces na pinakita natin is the gravity at saka yung spring. In other words, meron ng effect yung gravity at meron na rin, makikita na rin natin kung ano yung direction ng sa spring. What do you notice between the red and the blue arrow?
Constant po yung gravity, ma'am. Tapos yung spring po is ano, nag-iiba po siya.
Nagbabari yung force nung sa spring, ano? Pero yung direction, yes, what? Oh, okay. So what do you notice sa direction? Direction ng gravity at nung spring force.
Downward direction lang po yung gravity while yung sa spring po ay upward po.
Okay. So in other words, yung reaction ng spring or yung force ng spring is counteracting the gravity. Tama? Tama ba o mali? Okay. So tama yung conclusion na yon. Ibig sabihin, opposite direction ang spring force dun sa gravitational pull. Okay. So you would also notice na meron tayong displacement. Kanina ang ipinakita lang natin yung natural length. Dito ngayon meron ang ipinakitang displacement. Okay? So you can conclude that the gravitational force is directly opposite the spring force. Pero most probably it would have, hindi pa natin masasabi kung na-compute, hindi pa kasi nako-compute dito yung spring force. Pero pinapakita pa lang niya yung direction. So hindi natin pwedeng sabihin kung mas malaki ba yung spring force kaysa dun sa gravitational force. So in this case, ang pinapakita pa lang is yung direction. Okay? Let us try gumamit ng mas malaking ano dito. Mas malaking value. Okay. What do you notice when we increase the load for the first spring?
Nag-increase din po yung gravitational pull.
Mas sumapa po yung displacement.
Pero yung direction, may change ba sa direction?
Wala.
Wala po.
Walang change sa direction. How about the velocity and acceleration? What do you notice? Yung velocity, yung green arrow, yung mas malapad na green arrow. What do you notice dun sa green? Yung velocity.
From the velocity follows the direction of the acceleration.
Double check mo ulit yun. May chance na hindi, di ba? Ah, okay. Follows. Okay. Sige, you say follow. Yung direction, tingnan nyo nga yung direction. Tingnan yung direction ng velocity at nung spring. Pag bumababa yung spring, ano nangyayari doon sa green arrow? Yung larger green arrow, ha? Yung black. Ano nangyayari doon sa velocity? Pag bumababa yung spring, anong nangyayari doon sa velocity ang arrow?
Pababa din po.
Okay, pababa din yung direction, di ba? Pag yung spring umaangat na, tumataas na, anong nangyayari doon sa velocity arrow?
Tumataas din.
Tumataas din po.
Okay. So how about doon sa acceleration?
Pag pababa po, ma'am, yung spring, yung arrow po is pataas. Then pag pataas po, bumababa po yung arrow niya.
Baliktad ano, 'di ba? Pag bumababa yung spring, makikita yes. niyo yung arrow ng acceleration pataas. Pero pag umaakyat yung spring, yung acceleration pababa, 'di ba? Tama ako?
Yes po, ma'am.
Oh, so ano ang magiging conclusion natin doon? Pwedeng in terms of increase pag increase in velocity and decrease in velocity, increase in acceleration, increase decrease in acceleration. In other words, pag paakyat yung spring, anong pwedeng mangyari doon sa acceleration? Nababawasan ba o nadadagdagan pag paakyat yung spring?
Dadagdagan.
Inversely proportional, 'di ba? So pag paakyat yung spring, pag paakyat yung spring, most likely anong mangyayari sa acceleration?
Bumababa.
Nagde-decrease.
Bumababa po.
Oo, pwedeng mabawasan yung acceleration. Okay, so tama. Pag bumababa, pag pababa yung spring, ang direction ng motion ng spring ay pababa, yung acceleration posibleng mag yung acceleration, ano mangyayari? Pagpababa ang direction ng spring.
Tumataas po yung acceleration.
Very good. Okay, so mag-i-increase din. So that's how the relationship of all this would be shown. How about for energy? Let's say meron tayong kinetic energy here. Aside from the displacement, natural length, mass equilibrium and movable line, damping ratio. Okay. So, lagay lang muna natin na ang damping is zero. Okay. Related kasi ito sa building. Okay. Kapag ka merong earthquake, pwedeng mangyari itong ganitong condition. Okay. So, we will see what would happen once we add up a load here. What do you notice? What do you notice dun sa mga energy? Okay? We are now considering yung effect ng energy or effect ng load dun sa spring. It produces kinetic energy, potential energy due to gravity, then there is a potential energy due to the class, and then the total energy. What happens when we increase the load? What happens when we increase the load? Ano nakikita niyong change nung i-increase natin yung load? Anyone?
Mas tumataas po yung value ng kinetic energy and potential energy. Pero yung kinetic energy and potential energy po is inversely proportional po pagdating sa din sa mass equilibrium.
Okay, so mass equilibrium. So in other words, meron ng effect ngayon yung load dun sa energy. So babalikan natin yung pinag-discuss natin the last time. Let me stop my sharing here. Ah, sige, wag na, mamaya na lang. Yung diniscuss natin last time, tungkol sa inertia. Ang sabi natin, mas gusto natin, sa inyo ko ba yung na-discuss? Ano ang mas mataas ang inertia? Most likely, yung lightweight or yung heavyweight?
Yung heavyweight po.
Okay, so heavy, yung heavier load, yun ang mas mataas ang inertia. So may kinalaman din dito yon. So mas malaki din yung energy na nakikreate kung mas mabigat ang ating object. Okay? So later on, when you go to your higher design subject, let me stop my sharing here. Kapag ka nandun na kayo ngayon sa inyong higher design subject, you would now appreciate what's the relationship of all these physics concepts, laws and motions, energy, sa mga nakikreate na energy sa building, especially when there is an earthquake. Okay? Kapag ka ang isang structure subjected to earthquake, merong pag ang building subjected to earthquake, merong napoproduce na ano napoproduce kapag ka merong earthquake dahil merong motion? Go back to basic lang tayo, physics lang tayo. Kung merong motion, merong earthquake, ano ang napoproduce sa building?
Damage.
Nagkakaroon ng damage dahil?
Sa movement po.
Dahil sa movement, anong nangyayari sa building? Merong napoproduce na?
Crack, ma'am.
O kaya nagkakakrack, yun na nga yung damage. Merong movement. Physics tayo ha, physics. Ang tanong ko is...
Friction po ba?
Hindi, ang tanong ko is, merong earthquake. Nagkaroon ng earthquake dun sa building, sa location, sa area kung saan nandun yung building. Ano ang napoproduce nung earthquake?
Fault line po ba, ma'am?
Ang fault line, hindi pwedeng i-produce ng earthquake. Ang fault line, sadyang nandun na. May fault line na yon, may crack na doon sa, ibig sabihin kasi ng fault line, yun ay crack sa lupa. Okay? So merong gap sa lupa. Pag merong earthquake, ano ang napoproduce ng earthquake?
Force po.
Yung force na yon ay napoproduce, nagkakaroon ng force dahil sa earthquake. Dahil merong force, ano ang napoproduce pa?
Tsunami, ma'am.
Ay, tsunami. Malayo na yung tsunami. Malayo na. Ano tayo sa force? Bakit nakarating na tayo sa tsunami? Worst case scenario na yung nangyari. Ulit na. Nasa physics pa lang tayo. Nagkaroon ng earthquake doon sa location. Yung building subjected sa earthquake. Merong, sabi nyo, merong force. Yung force na yun nag-create ng ano?
Movement.
Ayan, nag-create ng movement. Tama, di ba? Nag-create ng movement. Tama yung intensity. Intensity level yan. Saka na natin i-discuss yung intensity. Medyo iba pa yon technically. Pero dahil merong force, merong movement, ano na po-produce ng movement?
Aftershock po.
Iba pa yung aftershock. Ulit. Merong may earthquake. Nagkaroon ng earthquake dahil merong napoproduce na force dun sa ilalim ng lupa. Yung force nag-create ng movement. So dahil nagkaroon ng movement, ano ang nakikreate?
Damage po.
Physics.
Inertia.
Hindi po ba ano?
Interaction. Oh, kasi meron nga interaction, merong motion. Ano anong na-create ng interaction at ng motion?
Opposite force po.
Nagkaroon ng ha? Kanina na may simulation na kanina eh, 'di ba? Anong dinagdag natin? Anong napansin niyo do sa dinagdag natin do sa simulation? Yan, energy. Energy, di ba? Nag-start tayo dun sa force. Di ba, dun sa nauna, wala. Nakalagay lang, merong spring. Nilagyan natin ang force. Tapos nagkaroon ng motion, may displacement, may velocity. Tapos dun sa pangatlong simulation, meron na tayong pinakitang energy. So may nakikreate na energy. So merong, pag merong energy, ano pa ang posibleng mangyari? Pag merong energy, anong posible nating ma-create? Pag merong energy na nakikreate? Ay, sorry. Energy cannot be created nor destroyed. Pero pag merong energy, ano pa yung kasunod na pwede mong makuha?
Damage.
Ay, oo, damage. Yung damage, ay, nagkaroon ng damage dun sa building. Kasi ang sitwasyon natin, earthquake eh. Nagkaroon ng damage dun sa building. Pero pag, in terms of physics, ano ang kasunod na makukuha natin pag merong energy?
Kinetic and potential po.
Oh, di ba may kinetic and potential energy? Pag meron kang energy na gano'n, ano ang mapuproduce natin? Ano mapuproduce natin pag meron tayong energy?
Force.
Sino kaya makakakuha nito? O may mechanical energy. O sige, may energy na. May mechanical energy. Ang tanong ko, pag merong mechanical energy, merong potential energy, may chemical energy, etc., etc., may energy. Basta may na-create na energy. Ano ang mapuproduce ng energy?
Power.
Yeah! Power. Very good power! Diba? Nagtrabaho ka, nagkaroon ng energy, may work. Nag-work, nagtrabaho. May nagkaroon na yung trabaho ang representation natin doon is ang representation natin doon sa sitwasyon na binigay ko ay earthquake. So merong work. Ang nag-work ay yung earthquake. Yung earthquake nakaproduce ng energy. Yung energy magpo-produce siya ng power. Yung power na yon ang nag-produce ng nagdala ng damage doon sa structure. 'Di ba? Yung power na na-create ng energy ang magpo-produce ng damage doon sa structure. So kung yung dinesign ng isang civil engineer na structure ay hindi sapat o hindi kayang suportahan yung power na na-create ng earthquake, yun ang magko-cause ng damage, failure or collapse doon sa building. So nakukuha nyo na kung ano ang kahalagahan ng physics sa isa trabaho ng isang civil engineer. Yun lang yung gusto kong ma-appreciate nyo. Eh para at least hindi niyo naiisip na yung physics ay physics lang. Kailangan nyo lang malampasan. Pero hindi eh. Kailangan yung matutunan kasi meron siyang kinalaman later on dun sa critical thinking ninyo kapag ka nandun na ka sa higher design subjects. Okay? Pag kayo na yung magde-design. So kung magde-design kayo ng structure, any engineering structure, babalik kayo dun sa basic. Babalikin ninyo yung fundamental. Fundamental ng physics. Okay? May natutunan po ba kayo? Okay. So, I hope and I'm glad that you have learned something from today. So, later on, we are going to have some more simulation so that you will have a great appreciation again of the relationship of all these physics concepts in engineering. Particularly civil engineering. Okay? So with that, thank you very much for your participation. I shall see you next meeting. Don't have any clarification? No more. Sige. So I meeting.